month, I've been inquiring as to whether Honda's update of the Goldwing, the new Goldwing Tour, would hit the stamp, or on the off chance that it would have been a flop. Honda sent the exquisite Mrs. Lam and I some plane tickets. They likewise got our tab for our lodging, grub, and a considerable measure of Shiner Box, probably so I could tell the entire world how splendid the 6th Gen Winnie is. What's more, I do mean a great deal of Shiner Box. We got frosted out for an entire day, which left me without any haggles in an inn bar. The cruiser is still unmistakably a Goldwing, however so much has changed from what the 5th Gen machine offered riders for so long. Too long, truly. Honda can't construct a Goldwing for each rider the way they need it. Unpractical. End of story. This bicycle is hard to audit for a similar reason it was hard to assemble. The Goldwing rider never again fits into a categorize. The Goldwing isn't a failure, however I don't know whether it's a grand slam, either. Honda has sold around 800,000 Goldwings since the model was presented, the greater part of them in America. Given the cost of that bicycle and number of them that Honda hawks, it must be genuinely evident that the huge Tourer is a benefit community for them. It's likewise their lead bike, the bicycle everybody knows. In any case, in the media introduction they gave, late deals seem, by all accounts, to be unobtrusive, with 2017 looking the most noticeably awful. Are visiting riders maturing out? Was 2017 deals information fragmented when that diagram was made? Is the Goldwing just agonizingly past due for an update? All things considered, those inquiries can be replied with an unequivocal yes. But still, you get the point, something needed to change. In their introduction, Honda had one slide that powerfully portrayed the clients they expected to catch: existing, has a Goldwing now; returning, had a Goldwing previously; and new, has not had a Goldwing yet. Step back for a moment and think about the ages, conjugal status, financial means, and riding styles of these riders. The 63-year-old wedded retiree on his third wing riding across the nation on the Reg presumably has a quite extraordinary rundown of requirements than the single 38-year-old IT fellow who jumps Slayer while attempting to benefit as much as possible from the incidental extended weekend. However, both are remarkably essential to the present and future strength of the G name. Goldwings and Goldwing Tours now utilize a shrewd key, which I discovered keenly set in this fuel tank stash that additionally housed the USB association point. Great work, Honda. Before climbing onto the bicycles, the primary gathering of authors slated to ride were all processing about. Some accepted the open door to acquaint themselves with the new data/route/diversion suite. I was among them. I fear this piece of taking in another bicycle. The greater part of these things turn out to be truly normal in the wake of riding a specific bike for half a month, however I once in a while have 14 days to test them. Mrs. Lam and I were not checking a comm framework, so there was no call to match it with the bicycle, however I had Mrs. Lam match up her iPhone to the Goldwing Tour Honda had us ride. She utilized Bluetooth, however, not Apple CarPlay, which the Goldwing is furnished with. Pairing was lickety part once we found the correct menu, which did not take long. That stated, we needed to wrench the radio and the telephone up to max volume to hear at partway speeds. This isn't the first occasion when I've encountered BT as an info having a nearly frail flag.